End cards are very important to YouTube videos. Why? It gives the people opportunity to see more of the content you create, and you kind of can introduce them or run them down a series if you are creating a series. You can sort of guide their next path on your other great content videos. Now, today in class, Taisha asked the question, how do you make those end cards? Me personally, I use Final Cut, and I have a plugin for Final Cut from Premium VFX. But today, I'm going to show you how to do this in Canva because it's one of the easiest ways to do it. Now, know this. Adobe Express can do this. Keynote can do this. PowerPoint can do this. There's a bunch of ways you can do it. Today, I'm showing you Canva because it's simple and it's easy, and a lot of you guys have Canva. And I believe this will totally work on a free version. I have a pro version, so if I pick something pro, just know that you might just have to chill out on the animation. But for the most part, it's going to work. Now, before we jump in the tutorial, please stick with me and stay to the end so you can see how to upload this and get everything how you want it. This is important. Paul said to me in class that a lot of people don't see all the way to the end of the video. And yeah, that your analytics might show that, and that might be true. But I always believe in giving your best effort all the way through for the people who actually spend the time to rock with you. I wanna rock with you. If you're gonna rock with me and watch all the way to the end, like Taisha does, then give the people what they want. Like, do the right thing. Don't just sort of half make your video because your analytics are freaking you out and telling you that people stop watching after like 2 minutes. That's why I don't look at analytics. Honestly, I'm the one weird coach out here that tells you I don't stare at analytics at all because I don't want it to make me make knee-jerk reactions. I want to give you the best value. And I believe those of you guys who stay all the way to the end, you deserve to be rewarded. And maybe that reward is point you to another video that's going to help you. So anyway, I think it's important. I never shortcut this. Let's dive in. As you know, I end my videos always the same way. This is sort of what it looks like right now. Right about now, the algorithm is going to show you another video they think you should watch, and I agree with them. Roll some music.
I need to know everything. Who in the what in the where? I need everything.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and give myself a C- on this call to action because I'm going to make some changes, compliments of the question that Taisha asked me today in class. For instance, I think you should only have one call to action, just one. So you'll see some end cards that has two videos. I think you should only do one because eliminating choice just makes people's lives easier, okay? So I'm gonna have one and I like to put mine dead center. You could do whatever you want, but this is just me. I am going to get rid of the social media stuff on the side because I think the social media is important if you're active on those platforms. I do post to Instagram. I'm almost never on Facebook except for work. And Twitter is now X, so I don't even be over there. So I'm going to go ahead and get rid of those. I don't think they're important because I think it's more important that you keep the bodies who are watching on YouTube stay on YouTube. So given another distraction, not really a thing. Now, I will keep my website and I will keep my Doc Pops logo because, well, I need to sell some pops. So that would be beneficial to me. And yeah, I'll be dead honest. That would be beneficial to me if you went to docmerch.com, you either bought some merch or you bought some pops. It helps keep the channel going. So I will leave that. The little big head thing you see on the side, that is a subscribe doohickey that if somebody wanted to subscribe to my channel, they'd click on my face and they would see that. That would allow them to subscribe. But I think a single video, maybe one website link and a logo if you're active. I think we should kind of get rid of the social media things on the side. If they want to find you on social media, they're going to look for you or they'll ask you or they'll DM you or they can see on your page when you go in. So we're going to ignore these from now on and let's just get over to Canva. Here we are in Canva. I'm going to look at the top and I am going to press on video. For my video, I'm going to go ahead and select 1080. Trust me, I'm going to switch it to 4K. And then I want to go here and I want to search backgrounds. These are busy. Let's go to gradient. Bingo. All right. So I'm going to look at my gradient. I'm looking at gradient videos. And a lot of these say pro. I need one that's kind of sort of free. Let's click on that. That works. I do. Ooh, that's busy. Stop that. Stop that. Ooh, God, no. The first thing we want to do is change this guy to 20 seconds because 20 seconds is what YouTube wants. Then we'll go back to elements. And then we're going to go look for gradients. And I'll click on videos. And this 16 would work, 17 would work. This 30 second would work. It's a little loud. I like them to be kind of basic. I don't want it to be too cray cray because that's just a little nasty. Yeah, let's just go back up here. I'll pick one of these. I don't want to spend all day playing this game. So I saw a 30 second in here somewhere. Here, let's just grab this 30 and we'll drop it in real quick. We're going to put it up there. We're going to go to here, embiggen it like such, and then at the top, go back to the trim situation and type in 20 again. All right, so now we have a 20-second clip. What I want to do now is go over to the elements, and I want to get rid of the word gradient. I want to click on the shape, which just basically gives me a box. I'm going to drop this box down to the bottom and then make this about 225. It doesn't have to be accurate. 225 is a good look. I'm going to stretch this way about across and way about across. And just for hyper contrast, I'm going to pick a darker color. So me being me, I'm going to just pick a purple. I don't say it matches, but for today, this is going to work. I'm going to click on the text here. Bingo. And I'm going to put in my link. Okay, and then I'm going to select my font that I normally use. Actually, I'll just use Futura Bold for this. And then I'm going to embiggen it to about 60, 70, something that looks good. All right, we'll call it that. Make it even. Don't make your job hard. And then I'm going to clickety-click that, turn it white for this particular case, and then bingo. Go ahead and drag that down to the bottom. And we're going to call that the day. Now, here's something that you cannot. It's totally up to you. I want to click on, let's look at some of these cute ones they got in here. None of this strikes me. Show me something pretty. And let's use happy birthday. You can say something like, watch this next. And then dot, dot, dot. That's a little demanding. You can adjust the verbiage how you want. I'm just showing you another option here. I don't know. Some people might not like that whole overly demanding situation, but I'm going to leave that. I'm going to unembiggen it a little bit, and I'm going to put that like right about here, and then I'm going to go get a row. Let's go to elements, click on arrow, and then I'm going to curvy it like this here. This arrow is horrible. I would probably draw my own arrows, but again, this is doing it the Canva way, so I'm trying to make it as simple as possible. Actually, let's do this and flip it back over. Okay, let's just do it like this. So we're going to say, watch this next. I know that I'm going to put my video in the middle, so what I'll do for now is give myself a reference by throwing this thumbnail in here. It's not that big. It's about yo big. I don't know what the exact dimensions are. I'm sure I can measure it and find out, but this is close enough to give me sort of that reference point, and you'll see how we can make this work in YouTube. Okay, so we're gonna leave that like so. I wish I had a hairier arrow, but I don't wanna make this tutorial long. Again, you can make these adjustments. So what I'm gonna do is click on this. I wanna go to animate, and I want to do something cool like, neon. Okay, bingo. We're going to call that dead. Then we're going to actually, and we want this on enter because we're never going to exit. Okay, cool. We're going to take this guy and tumble it in. Nope, wrong way. Boom, that looks good. I would use a straight arrow normally for that. And for this one, I am just going to rise it up from the bottom and we're going to slow the speed up a little bit. All right, cool. We're going to call this the animation. So all I want to do now is go ahead and share this and press download. I will boom it up to 4K because that's how your boy rolls, and then just let it do its thing. While it's doing this particular thing right here, I'm going to take us over to Final Cut and kind of show you how I do my traditional way. Okay, so in here, I have a plugin that is called Editor Advanced. Take that back. Ooh, he went way crazy. It's called Editor Starter Kit. And inside here, I have InScreen. And this is the InScreen that I currently use. Okay? You guys recognize this. The only thing different is at the bottom, instead of having it plain, I went down here and I have some weird textures that I have from some other plugin. And I just use one of these random textures. And I have no idea which one it is. But I think it's this one here. Something like this. and I just have that texture at the bottom. And so I have this sitting on top of that texture, and it looks kind of cool because I changed the opacity of this thing. Anyway, we're not going to mess with that. I just wanted to just show you like how I created mine. Mine is a weird combination of textures. As a matter of fact, I just realized I could just steal it from here. Make this a heck of a lot more common sense for you guys so you can see. Now, the other thing I did is I made this guy 20 seconds. So you just kind of stretch it out till it's roughly 20 seconds. And there's my 20. And then I just make this match. So when you see my video, what you're seeing is this come up like this. Now, the only thing different in doing it in Final Cut versus Canva is I would come up in here. Now that I no longer care about the social media things, I'm going to just take the icons and put them to zero. And maybe I would take the follow-up videos and say, watch this video next. Give it the dot, dot, dot treatment. Come over here, select my font, M-O-N-T. And then press enter. Go here, select my black, and then embiggen it to something like that. And then I would just use my XY coordinates to kind of like bring it down. Hey, pay attention. Bring it down like that. Maybe mess with my sort of tracking so it's not so crazy. And then just sort of position it wherever I wanted it to go using the Final Cut controls. Okay. So anyway, that's good enough. Let's go back and show you the one that we just downloaded. I'll take this one and move it out the way for now. So let's X that out. This is what we just created. I'm going to put it here. And then in Final Cut, at the end of your video, you're just going to place this. And I don't need to do anything else because this is sort of just perfect. Let me render out this movie real quick and we're going to upload it so that you can see sort of how this works. Okay, let's go ahead and press test. Bingo, bango. Let it write that to the desktop real quick. We're going to pop back over to YouTube and we're going to upload this and give you an opportunity to see what this looks like. So we're going to go to upload video. And then I'm going to bring in that test movie that I just rendered to the desktop. We're going to put it there. Let it do its thing. All right. And we can skip this. We don't care about any of this because this is just a test. I will have to select my monetization to off. I'm going to go to video elements. Now, right now, down here on the bottom, it says uploading and it's telling me how long it's going to take to upload. So we can't do anything to the video right now. We're going to give this a second to upload and process, and then we will carry on. So I'll be right back. Okay, now all we're doing is just waiting for the check-in to happen. But while we're waiting for the check-in to happen, what I can do is go to, say, add an end card to this. Now, a couple things you can do. You can bring in one from a previous video. So you can say import from a video. And if I clicked on my yesterday's video, you'll get my standard look. And you'll see there's a subscribe element, there is the playlist element, and what I would do is just simply embiggen this clip to make it as big as can, maybe move it closer to the arrow, and then if we were to watch that play, okay, I'm going to move that back to the center because I don't want it to go underneath, and that is basically what my end card would look like. Now, let's say you have never made an end card, so you do not have this. Let me discard the changes because it's quicker. And I'm going to go to say add. What I would do is go to add an element. And my first element I'm going to add is this subscribe. And that's this big guy right here. But I'm going to put my subscribe doohickey over here on the end. Because then when it plays, it's kind of sort of out of the way. Right? And again, you can kind of move where you want that to be. All right? So you could also say show the outline, in which case we don't. I'm going to just leave it like that. Then I would, towards the beginning here, right when the arrow is in position, I'm going to bring in the next element, which would either be a video or a playlist. I tend to do playlists. You could do a direct video. Let's just pick a video for this. I'm just going to move it into position. And again, I like to embiggen it to as large as it'll go and just find the little arrows will help you put this in position. I like to make them come in staggered. So I just move this over just a smidgen so that they come in staggered. So if we were to rewind this video to where you see me and Tanya talking, Tanya, I go like this, and then the video just pops up, and then there's a little arrow telling you to watch this video next. That is the whole end all be all. So let me go ahead and save that, and that would show up if we were to go ahead and publish this video. Let's make it unlisted. And we were to watch this on YouTube after it's finished publishing. So let me click it and then click here and then come over to about right here and let it play through. It should end any second now. There we go. It's coming. It's coming. I promise. There it is. And then so that's what your end card would look like if you did it just making your end card in Canva. Now, one last thing before we go, again, make these in Canva. And yes, Canva does have templates. As a matter of fact, let me boop over real quick and show you what the templates look like. If I were to go to design here and type in end card or end screen, you'll see Canva does have some templates here. My only thing about these templates is they are a wee bit outdated. So maybe if you find one like this that just has a single video, this is kind of good, but just make sure you change it a little bit. So all of the different programs, Canva, Express, they all have these templates. Just make your own. It's not that hard. You just need a space to put the video, a call to action, a website, and a logo if you got them. Keep them super simple. And again, give people one option. Now, one last thing. Notice at the end of my videos, I don't normally say bye or aloha or whatever. I literally say, right about now, the algorithm is going to show you another video they think you should watch, and I agree with them. Some people will say, if you like this video talking about the Lamy Safari Fin, if you look right here, there'll be, what's on this side, I believe. If you look right here, there'll be another video where I talk about the Pilot Preppy. So if you know you're going down a series, say you're like, you know, Kathy, and you're doing recipes, you might say, right here, I'm going to show you where I'm going to make this next recipe about this type of ice cream or something, this whole food plant-based ice cream. So you can, some people finish them by saying what the next video is because they know, because they're cool people and they plan their content like that. Some people would just say they're going to put another video thing you should watch here. That'd be cool. But yeah, get out of the habit of saying bye. It's just, you want people to stay and watch more videos. And again, people, the best thing you can do as a viewer for a channel, if you like that creator, watch more than one of their videos, like their videos, comment on their videos. Subscribing, that's a whole different topic. We'll deal with that later date. But that, my friends, is how you do it in Canva. If you want to see me do it in a different program, let me know that in the comment section below, and I will get to it and show you how. Thank you, Taisha and Paul, for that great conversation about end cards today. And you even made me realize I should change some of the stuff on mine, because one call to action, no socials unless you really want them leaving YouTube, and only a website if that website is active. Thank you again, Rich, for pointing out a couple of my websites that are broken that I'm fixing now. But right about now, the algorithm is going to show you another video I think you should watch. I agree with him.
I need to know everything. Who in the what in the where? I need everything. Trust me, I hear what you're saying, but I like it's new what you're telling me. I'm curious, George. I hop in the Porsche, a five and a horse. I'm ready for war. I'm coming for throws to turn to a ghost. I need to know everything. Now you'll be surprised at the info you get is by letting them talk, so I'm letting them talk. Gotta keep quiet, maneuver, and sign.